Hello dear students, today I will continue the chapter limits and derivatives with exercise 13.2. So just in the previous class we have seen that the finding derivative at a point and also finding derivative in general, that is function of derivative as again a function of x by using first principle method. So here we will solve the questions one by one. There is derivative at a point, just we know the for finding derivatives means finding limit. Okay, so limit finding you know by using some special formula also. So here solution of question first 13.2. So here just we have to find what x square minus 2 at x equal to 10. So we have to find the derivative of x square minus 2 at x equals to 10. That is derivative of function at a point. Point means 10. So let fx equals to x square minus 2. This is our function. And point A equals to 10. Okay. By definition, of derivative at a point A we have f dash A derivative of the function at point A is equals to what? Limit h tending to 0 here h and here f a plus h minus f a. Clear? So just use a equals to 10. So implies we can write f dash limit s tending to 0 h f 10 plus h minus f 10. Okay, so fx equal to this, here fx means 10 plus h, so limit, just we will find this limit, 10 plus h square minus 2, this is the value of this function, f, minus n square minus 2 by using this definition f and upon now limit h tending to 0 our target is finding limit. So for finding limit just solve it. 10 plus h square plus 20h plus h square minus 2 minus 100 plus 2. So we are getting like this for solving upon h. So here we see that 10 square 100 minus 100 minus 2 plus 2 cancel out. So 20h plus h square. So h can be taken common. So limit h tending to 0, h common, so 20 plus h upon h. So h cancel. So here we see that limit h tending to 0, 20 plus h. So this is equals to 20 plus 0 equals to 20. So this is all. Well, of m dash a. Derivative of this at 10, x equal to 10, 20. Clear? So this is by the definition at a point derivative. Okay. Similarly, second question. Question second also can be find here. Function is what? 99x at x equal to 100. 99x at x equal to 100. Okay. So, x and x equal to 100. So 99x. Okay. 99x at x equal to 100. So point is 100. So let's suppose 99x, this is our function. Point is 100. Then this is the definition. Just a equals to 100. So we can write like this, limit h tending to 0, f in place of a, just write 100 plus h minus 100. Okay, divided by h. Clear? So here, limit h tending to 0, this is equals to, according to this definition, 99 into 100 plus h. By using definition, f x equal to this, 99 to x in place of x, a plus h, a means 100 plus h. F 100, 99 into 100. And here h. Just also we see that now 9900 minus 9900 cancel out 99h. So limit h tending to 0 99h upon h. So this is equals to limit h tending to 0 99 equals to 99. This is the derivative at point 100 also, 99. Because h is cancelled, 99 constant, constant is outside, so there is no h, so 99 is the derivative. Okay, question third is also, we can do derivative of x at x equal to 1. So derivative of x, question third means, just you have to do by using formula at a point in this x. At 1. So this is suppose x, this is 1, then here will be 1, here will be 1.
So very simple for finding. This is 1, f dash at a equals to 1. So we can get value as fx equal to x, that is f 1 plus h equals to 1 plus h fx equal to x minus f 1 x equal to 1. Now what 1 1 cancel, h upon h equals to limit h tending to 0 1 equals to 1. So 1 is derivative. Very simple. Main thing is this is the definition. Derivative at a point. Clear? So this formula is very, very important. So remember it. Okay. And we can also find the derivative just like this for using formula. Direct derivative. So the first question was what? X square minus 2. The fx equals to this. Okay, direct derivative means what? Direct derivative means, well, here function is what? Fx equals to x square minus 2. Just find derivative and then put the point. That is like this. F dash a equals to what? F dash x at x equals to a. That is, okay. So here f dash x means what? Dy dx fx and dy dx fx means x square minus 2. This is polynomial, secondly. So we can differentiate dy dx x square minus dy dx 2. Now it can be solved. 2x minus 0. So 2x. So here f dash x equals to 2x. Now f dash a, that is f dash 10, or target f dash 10. So f dash 10, x equal to 10. So 2 into 10 equals to 20. So this is it. Okay. Similarly, for second question, 99x. Okay, so here will be what? 99x. And at the point x equal to 100, f dash 100. So it can be solved, constant outside, dy dx, x. What? 99 into 1, 99. So derivative is 99. Now, f dash 100. So here f dash x equal to this, x may be anything because here nothing as x. So 99 also f dash 100. Similarly for x, just you can take only x and this is equals to 1, f dash x equals to 1. So f dash 1 equals to also 1. So this is the direct method and formula. X to the power n derivative n x to the power n minus 1. Okay. So this is by direct definition and this is the direct method, that is using derivative of polynomials and derivative of function x to the power n. We know n x to the power n minus 1 can be used. See here, question 4. Question 4 is given. Find the derivative of by using first principle method. Okay, first principle method means we can find the derivative of the function as a also another function, but use first principle method. That is formula you have to use for finding derivatives. Okay. So questions 4, there are four parts under this. Find the derivative of the following function from first principle method. Say x cube minus 27. So here question 4 first. So let first function, let fx equals to x cube minus 27, x cube minus 27. So here see that nothing is about point, at which point. So we have to find general. Method is the first principle method. Then using first principle, method, we get f dash x, that is derivative of x, that is dy dx fx is equals to what? Limit s tending to 0 h f x plus h minus fx. This is first principle method, fx plus h minus fx upon x, just at a point in place of a, here x. So we can get a function of x, another function, derivative is also a function of x. So by using this, this is the first principle method, by using this method we can find the derivative of a function by finding limit. Okay, so all the trigonometric functions, for the trigonometric functions we can find the derivative, and initial formula are derived from this formula. Okay, so here just put the value of the function here, fx plus h, fx equal to this, so x plus h equals to x plus h cube minus 27. This is the value of this, and fx equals to x cube minus 23, x cube minus 27 upon h. Now our target is finding the limit, just not substituting h equal to 0 now, just after reducing this, try to find definite value by putting h equals to 0 here. Okay, so just solve it. H tending to 0, here a plus b whole cube, so a cube plus b cube plus 3 a b square, 3 a square b minus 27, this is our formula. Okay, minus x cube minus minus plus 27, so 27 27 cancel, x cube cancel, and here h, so h can be taken common, so we can take common s tending to 0, so h common, so h square plus 3xh plus 3x square. Okay, now h can be cancelled out because h is not equal to 0, h is tending to 0, so we get limit h tending to 0, here h square plus 3xh plus 3x square. So this is equals to, now you can put h equals to 0. So here h, 0 square plus 3x into 0 plus 3x square, this equals to 3x square. So this is the derivative of this function. It is also a function of x. Okay, so this is first principle. By using this we can find derivative of all the remaining functions. Here also we can use direct method for finding derivatives. Direct method means just differentiate it as a polynomial. So see here, fx equals to what? X cube minus 27. So f dash x equals to dy dx fx. means dy dx x cube minus 27. Just as a polynomial, just distribute this derivative x cube term by term dy dx 27. This formula we know. What is formula? Our formula is x to derivative of x to the power n equals to n x to the power n minus 1. This is our formula. So by using this formula we can differentiate it. Dy dx x cube. What? 3x, 3 minus 1. Minus derivative of constant is 0. So this is equals to what? 3x square. This is by direct differentiating using derivative of polynomials. You can also get by using this technique. Okay. So take any other questions from here. So here second question is x minus 1, x minus 2. That is, you can use product rule also, and also by multiplying, making it polynomial, and then you can use direct derivatives. And also by taking this product rule can be used, or first principle method also can be used, just in the same way. Okay. So for third question, 1 by x cube, it can be also find by using this method, first principle method. So here let's take question. Fourth part of question 4, because second and third is just you have to do from yourself. Okay, in your copy, just in the same way by using first principle method. So here, fourth part, this function is given, what? X plus 1 by x minus 1, x plus 1 by x minus 1 is given, this is function. So we can find limit x tending to 0, here this is equals to, this is x plus 1 upon x minus 1. So here we can write fx plus x plus h plus 1 upon x plus h minus 1, minus fx, this x plus 1 upon x minus 1 upon h. Clear? Now, just solve it by taking LCM in the numerator. Okay. So, limit x tending to 0, 1 by h. And we get, by taking LCM, we can get x plus h plus minus 1 into x minus 1 in the denominator here. And numerator will be what? X minus 1 into this, x plus h plus 1 into x minus 1 minus x plus 1 into x plus h minus 1. This is after doing taking LCM. Okay. So here we see that up to now we cannot put the h equals to 0, because h 0, that is denoted 0. So here just we are trying to removing h. So just here multiply it. 1 by h okay, multiplying it, this into this. So x into x square plus xh plus x minus x minus h minus 1. This first multiplication minus in bracket. Just multiply in the second part. X square xh minus x plus x plus h minus 1.
this
upon x plus h minus 1 x minus 1. Okay, now limit s tending to 0, here 1 by h, and see here x square, just cancel out quantity, this is cancel, x square and x square cancel, xh cancel, because minus sign is there, and x and this x is cancel, and now minus 1 and minus plus 1 cancel, so minus h is here, and here x and x cancel, here minus h, minus 2h, so minus 2h upon x plus h minus 1 x minus 1, so this is equals to h cancel, so limit s tending to 0 minus 2 upon x plus h minus 1 x minus 1, this. Now here we see that if h equals to 0 we put, then we can get a definite value for just like this, minus 2 upon x plus 0 minus 1 x minus 1, so this is equals to minus 2 upon x minus 1 square, so this is our answer, minus 2 upon x minus 1 square, derivative of this. This is by using first principle method, just we are doing the process for finding the limit, this limit, this is the first principle method, derivative of first principle by first principle method. Okay, here we see that we know also division formula, rational formula, x plus 1 is numerator, x minus 1 is in the denominator, so also we can find its derivative by using numerator upon denominator formula. Okay, so as mentioned in the question, if it is given that for find the derivative by using first principle method, we will use this method. If not, and how marks are allotted for the questions, if short questions, then you can use direct method. Okay, as numerator and denominator, that is, this is division rule can be used and multiplication rule can be used, means product rule or derivative. Okay, so here if we use division rule, so division rule we know, what is division rule? That is numerator upon denominator, its derivative is equals to what? Denominator square upon d into n dash minus n into d dash, dash means derivative. So this is division rule. So by using this rule also you can find its derivative. Just like this, f dash x is equals to dy dx fx. That is dy dx x plus 1 upon x minus 1. So here numerator is x plus 1, denominator is x minus 1. So using this rule, using this rule, we can write this is equals to what? Denominator square. This. Here denominator. And derivative of numerator x plus 1 minus numerator x plus 1 derivative of denominator x minus 1, this is using formula. Now it can be solved, x minus 1 square is in the denominator, here x minus 1 into derivative wise, just you can distribute it. So d by dx of x plus d by dx of y, just this, okay, minus, just similar here, x plus 1 into derivative of x minus derivative of 1. Now here we see that x minus 1 into this, x minus 1 is square denominator, and this here 1, 0. So 1 plus 0 minus x plus 1, same 1 minus 0. So here we can solve it. How? 1 into this, x minus 1 minus x plus 1 upon x minus 1 square. So here we see that x cancel, minus 1 minus 1 minus 2. So minus 2 upon x minus 1 square. So we can get same answer by using division. Okay, so by any method we can find derivative as same function of x. Okay, this division rule, also called quotient rule, and we can also use which first principle method. Here first principle method is necessary when the in the questions it is given that by find derivative by using first principle method. Otherwise, you can use also division rule, multiplication rule, derivative of polynomials. Okay. The remaining parts of the question 4, second and third, just you have to do in your copy. Okay. Now take question 5. Question 5 is given, for the function, we have to prove f dash 1 equals to 100. F dash 0. Here the polynomial function is given, 100 degree polynomial is there, degree is 100. Okay, so given question 5, given the function as fx equals to x to the power 100 y 100 plus x to the power 99 upon 99 plus and so on x square by 2 plus x power 1 by 1 plus 1. This is given. Okay, this is given. It is a polynomial of 100 degree. Okay, and we have to show that f dash 1 equals to 100 f dash 0. So this is our target. So find the left hand value and right hand value. That's f dash, derivative at 1, derivative at 0. So here we use direct method. Okay, direct method. By using derivative of polynomial real function, by using derivative of polynomial function f dash x equals to it is d by dx equals fx equals to what? D by dx equals to, in place of fx, just put this, write this, means by 100 plus x to the power 99 by 99 plus and so on, x square by 2 plus x plus 1. Okay, this. Now, derivative of polynomial function, just we can differentiate term by term. So, distribute it. Just like this, d by dx, x to the power 100 upon 100 plus d by dx, x to the power 99 upon 99 plus d by dx, x to the power 2 upon 2 plus d by dx, x plus d by dx, y. Clear? So this is equals to, here 1 by 100 constant, so d by dx, x power 100, 1 by 99 constant, so d by dx, x power 99, same, 1 by 2, d by dx, x square plus 1 plus 0. We know this, its value is 1 and divide dx 1 0. So here 1 by 100 into 100 x to the power 100 minus 1 plus 1 by 99 x to the power 99 minus 1 plus 1 by 2 2 into x to the power 2 minus 1 plus 1. Since d by dx x to the power n equals to n x to the power n minus 1. This is the formula, d by dx x to the power n equal to n x minus, to the power n minus 1. So here 100 100 cancel, x to the power 99 plus here x to the power 98 plus and so on, x plus 1. Just we are getting this f dash x equals to. Derivative of function is also a function of x, that is also a polynomial. Now, left hand side we have to find. Okay. We are getting this. So we get f dash x equals to x to the power 99, x to the power 98 plus x plus 1, 99 degree polynomial. Therefore, left hand side. Now, we have, or we see that left hand side f dash 1, left hand side is f dash 1. So f dash 1 f dash 1, that is what? F dash x at x equals to 1. That means what? Just using this derivative. In this derivative, x to the power 99 plus x to the power 98 plus up to x plus 1, x equals to 1. In place of x, we have to put 1. So 1 for 99 plus 1 for 98 plus one plus one. Here how many times? 100 times. So what? Now 1 plus 1 plus 1 up to 100 times. So we can get the value as 100. F dash 1, 100. Left hand side is 100.
Okay.
Left hand side equals to 100. Therefore, left hand side equals to 100 we see here. Okay. Now, right hand side. Okay. Now we have to find right hand side. That is 100 into f dash 0. Now right hand side, and also right hand side 100 into f dash 0. Okay, that means what? 100 into f dash x at x equals to 0. That is 100 x to the power 99 plus x to the power 98 plus x plus 1 at x equals to 0. Now put the value x as a 0. So 0 power 99, 0 power 98, 0 plus 1. Only 1 is there. So 100 into 1 equals to 100. So right hand side is also 100. That is, right hand side is equals to 100. Hence proved. So systematically you have to write and find the value, and then you can get the required result. Okay. So here, just second question, question 6 also we can take. Question 6, in the question 6 we have to find the derivative of a polynomial. We have just given function as a polynomial and we have to find derivative, or a is some fixed real number. Question 6, let fx equals to given polynomial x to the power n. Okay. X to the power n. Given polynomial as x to the power n. A x to the power n minus 1 plus a square x to the power n minus 2 plus a n minus 1 x plus a n. Okay. Where a is some fixed real number. Clear? And we have to find its derivative. Real number, that is as a constant, we can treat in the time of differentiation. Okay. So, a and its power can be taken outside of the derivative symbol. Okay. So, see. Then, f dash x is equals to dy dx. as we know that the derivative of polynomial, we can write like this, dy dx of, just write its value, a x to the power n minus 1 plus a square x to the power n minus 2 plus and so on, a n minus 1 x plus a power n, this, just using, then using derivative of polynomial. We get this, okay. So implies f dash x, just we can term by term differentiate and distribute here, dy dx x to the power n, first part, second dy dx a x to the power n minus 1 dy dx a square x to the power n minus 2 dy dx n minus 1 x plus dy dx a power n, this, okay. So this symbol is not required here, okay. Now just use this formula, since derivative of x to the power n equals to n x to the power n minus 1. We know this is formula, this is a special formula for finding derivative. So n x to the power n minus 1 plus a constant can be taken outside, dy dx x to the power n minus 1. Here also constant can be taken outside because a to the power 2 is also as a constant for derivative. Here a to the power n minus 1 is outside. So dy dx of x plus this is 0. Derivative of constant is 0. A to the power n is constant. So now we can write using this formula, a n minus 1 n minus 1 and x to the power n minus 1 minus 1 minus plus a square n minus 2 x to the power n minus 2 minus 1 plus and so on, a to the power n minus 1 its value 1 into x to the power 1 minus 1 plus 0 is not required, okay. So this we get, so finally we get x to the power n minus 1 into a x to the power n minus 2 n minus 2 into a square x to the power n minus 3 plus a to the power n minus 1. So this is final derivative. Okay, so this is the final answer. So by using derivatives of polynomial, you can find derivative of the function. Okay. Now, question 7. Find derivative of product, square, and division. So, by using first principle method, you can also find, but we can also use direct method here. So there are three parts of the question 7. First part, product. Second part, power form. We can break this power and we can get a polynomial. So that can be differentiated by using this rule. Okay. Also, you can use product rule formula. Or polynomial formula. Okay. So here 7. Question first. Let given function. What is here a, b are constant, x minus a, x minus b. So let fx equals to x minus a into x minus b, where a and b are constant. Constant, okay? Then you can use product rule or by multiplying use derivative of polynomial. Then using product rule, we get f dash x is equals to d by dx of fx, d by dx of fx means x minus a into x minus b. Product rule is u v dash equals to u dash v plus d into v dash. Product rule. Clear? So here u means this, v means this. So derivative of x minus a into b this plus x minus a into derivative of b this. Okay, now this is constant a b, so its derivative dy dx x minus dy dx a x minus b plus x minus a dy dx x minus dy dx b. So this is what? Derivative of this is 1 by using this rule, minus this constant 0, so x minus b plus x minus 1 a, so a here 1 minus 0. Okay, so here we see 1 into this means x minus b plus x minus a, so this is 2x minus a minus b, so derivative is f dash x equal to this. So we are getting derivative what? F dash x equals to 2x minus a minus b. Okay, just now see by using derivative of polynomial. So here you can see if we use the another method we can also get solution just like this. This is given, so fx equals to, we can also get by multiplying x square minus ax minus bx plus ab. So this is what? Fx equals to x square minus, just take common second degree polynomial, you get second degree polynomial. So by using derivative of polynomial we get just term by term differentiate f dash x equals to d by dx fx d by dx, write the value of fx here, okay, x square minus a plus b into x plus a. Okay, now distribute it. Divide dx, x square, as term by term differentiation by using derivative of polynomial. Minus divide dx, a plus b into x, this, plus divide dx of ab. Here ab, a constant, b constant, ab is also constant. Derivative constant is 0. So here, by using this formula, that formula, 2 x to the power 2 minus 1 minus constant outside and derivative of x 1 into x to the power 1 minus 1 and its value 0. So here we see that 2x, x to the power 1, 2x minus a plus b. This is x to the power 0 means 1. So this is 0. So finally we get 2x minus a minus b. So derivative. By both rule, we get same value, 2x minus a minus b, 2x minus a minus b. So you can use any of the method just by using derivative of polynomial and also using derivative of derivative of product by using product rule. So 7 in the question 7, so second is also ax square plus b whole square, so break it whole square, then you can get a polynomial and you can differentiate by term by term and get result. And third is x minus a upon x minus b. You can use division rule, numerator by denominator. Okay. So do this question to second and third of seventh and also all the questions of today's class and also try to solve all the examples in your copy and send me 2-3 questions for your attendance. Okay.